Hey, welcome everyone to yet another Gitty Gang Show. Guess what number this week is?
200 and something.
Yeah, 208. This is our 208th show, plus or minus. We counted last week's show. Shane was good enough to take it over. We were, by golly, last Friday, it was a snowstorm going on. I think by 3 p.m. there was nobody at Gitty. Yeah. They got the orders out early in the day, the lights were off, and everybody went home. So thank you, Shane, for taking last week's show. We do appreciate that. Speaking of our Shane, he's been wicked busy these last couple of weeks. Hopefully you have seen the newsletter that got sent out, the Facebook posts and such, but a new line of kits designed by Shane. Basically, what he did was he took our Tupelo tenor, our Mountain tenor, and our Hubcap Howler tenor guitar kits and created wraparound printed graphics to print on the box. So we print them here and ship them out. You put them together and end up with an awesome looking, fully printed, amazing guitar. We'll be showing a video a little bit later that Shane has put together showing off the three that he built as part of getting all of this ready to release. Those kits, we're calling them the Red Barn Series, and they're now available on cbgitty.com exclusively. So yeah, that's good. You'll see more of that in a little bit, possibly in the third half of today's show. Always been really good at math, so that makes a lot of sense. Other announcements, the New Orleans Cigar Box Guitar Festival is coming up again in 2023, January 19th through the 21st. We are all hopeful that this year we will be able to do it in person, that all of the reasons over the last 2 years that it had to be canceled will no longer be anything to worry about. So today we are going to run the three winning videos of the 2022 New Orleans Cigar Box Guitar Festival video contest. Dozens and dozens of entries from all around the world came in for that. I was not directly involved in the judging. I did indicate my three favorites from the top 10, but was not one of the judges. So I'm happy to announce, we are happy to announce, it went out in a newsletter already, but the three winners, really awesome stuff. So we'll be running those videos later. Also a short aside, the Eastwood Station inaugural album is now available on cbgitty.com as a digital download. So if you don't want the physical CD, you can buy it. It's just $10 instead of $12.50, and you can get your digital hands on a copy of those 12 tracks and put them on your phone, play them in your car, wherever you want. So that's good things. What else is coming up? Anything in the next couple of weeks? J-Dub's birthday. Holy moly. See, I'm on the YouTube here. I got to mash the button to get over to the Facebooks where these kinds of things are getting announced. So happy birthday, Janice Wilson Hughes, slide maker, extraordinaire, potter, musician, cigar box guitar builder, and writer of very nice notes. If you ever happen to order slides directly from her, you might get one of those nice notes.
We have several pinned up.
I've received a number of them. The other big thing coming up in just 13 days from today is St. Patrick's Day. And as you know, around here, we enjoy such things. So we're going to do a couple of Irish and Irish-inspired, modern things, all sorts of good stuff. And we've got a bunch of great videos for you as well. William Edward White is on the lineup. Our good buddy Kale down at Porna Studios is on here. Shane Spiel is going to be demoing those new Red Barn kits as only he can. Boy, he really makes that Tupelo tenor scream, doesn't he? Mm-hmm. It's the electric version of the kit that has one of those lipstick tube pickups in it. Whew. He runs it through its paces, that's for sure. Then we've got the videos of the winners of the contest and a video of a first-time submitter, I think, down Dean Lindquist.
Yep, from Claire's out there in Alberta.
Claire's Home, Alberta, which is still in Canada, sent in a cool one of a couple of brothers playing one of his most recent builds. So, all sorts of good stuff. Let's do one of those Irish things there, Danny. One that we've been rehearsing a bit with our new band, Off She Goes. Unfortunately, all the she's off and went. None of them are here today. But it's a 5-member band of Danny, myself, and 3 ladies, and we put on our first full official gig last night downstairs at the brewery, and what a time it was. Whole lot of crack, that's all I'm gonna say. You ready? Here's one of the good old traditional ones.
Tell my ma when I go home, the boys won't leave the girls alone. Hold my hair, stole my comb, and that's all right, I go home. She is handsome, she is pretty, she's the belle of Belfast City. She is courting 1, 2, 3, please won't you tell me who is she? Albert Mooney says he loves her, all the boys are fighting for. Knock on the door and ring the bell, say, no, my true love, are you well? There she goes, as white as snow, rings on her fingers and bells on her toes. Hope Jenny Murray says she'll die if she doesn't get the fellow with a roving eye. Hey, tell my ma when I go home, the boys won't leave the girls alone. Hold my hair, stole my comb, that's all right, I go home. She is handsome, she is pretty, she is Belle of Belfast City. Apple pie, and she'll get her own that by and by. When she gets a lad of her own, won't tell the ma when she comes home. Let the boys pray as they will, it's Albert Mooney she loves still. Hey, tell my ma when I go home, the boys won't leave the girls alone. Hold my hair, stole my comb, that's all right, I go home. She is handsome, she is pretty, she's the belle of Belfast City. She is courting 1, 2, 3, please don't tell me who is. One more, tell my ma when I go home, the boys won't.
I'm used to doing those little interludes on the mandolin, not the banjos. I'm like, uh-oh, it's more of a stretch. So thank you everyone for joining us. We have Jim Morris out there, the one and only. God bless you, Jim. Keith Rierich, Michael Capato, Mr. Jimbo Burt. Speak of the one and only. Mm-hmm. Jim Burt.
Roll Tide.
Roll Tide, Jim Burt. Max Whedon have Tim Henderson's out there. By God, Rob Robel, John Matrician. Man, all the good. And that's just Facebook. Gordon Peter. Hers Glove over there in the UK. Who we got on YouTube? Ken Hope down there in Olive Branch, Georgia. Good to see you, buddy. Richard Stump. Steve Holliday, one of the top 10 finishers of the video contest. Good to see you. Man, what a great day it is. Dana Valley, inventor of the B-Bender Relapse B-Bender kit. We just got that batch of 25 in today. Laurel's busy in there packaging them up, and we're going to get them back on sale. Briefly sold out of the double and triple kits on those. Popular stuff. If you don't remember, the B-Bender system that Dana invented allows you to add pitch bending to pretty much any guitar instrument that has a top-loading hard tail-style bridge. Really cool stuff. Oh, just this week, there was a video someone uploaded to YouTube showing off what they can do. Really awesome stuff. All right, so let's get to our first video now. Enough talking out of me. So William, still a little hoarse from last night. We did a lot of singing last night. We went over the 3-hour mark. We still didn't get through our entire set list because somebody put too many things on it or did too much talking in between songs. Anyway, here is William Edward White. He's playing another build with the body built from a pool triangle for racking pool balls. So kind of like a balalaika inspired. He calls them a puluk, something like that. He liked the first 3 he sold so much, he built one for himself. So we say, right? Although people always told me, like, some of these instruments I've built and decided to keep, they're like, you'll sell them eventually. Doing all right so far, that one. Anyway, This is about William Edward White, and here he is singing All of Me.
You took the path that once was my home. Why not take all of me? All of me. Why not take all of me? Can you see? I'm no good without you. Take my lips, I wanna lose them. Take my arms, you know I'm never gonna use them. Your goodbye left me with eyes that cry. How can I go on day without you? You took the part that once was my heart. Why not take all of me? Take my lips, I wanna lose them. Take my arms, you know I'll never use them. Your goodbye left me with eyes to cry. Well, how can I go on dear without you? You took the path that once was my heart. Why not take all of us? And you took the best. Come back for the rest. Why not take all of me?
Well, thank you for sending that in, man. That's one of those good old jazz standards, and hearing it played on an interesting homemade instrument like that, that's pretty cool stuff. Well done, sir. All right, how about something which, while technically Irish, is not normally considered traditional Irish, although I guess it's old enough now to be at least vintage.
Yes.
Irish.
Makes me feel old because I remember the song coming out.
Yeah, me too. From that, those new kids out of Ireland there, We Four?
Yeah.
No, you two.
Yes.
And he's gonna do a harmonica solo on it, by God.
Hopefully I can do it, not mess it up.
Yeah.
Ken Hope said we should turn up Danny's mic. We're using these little lapel mics today. During the next
video, way down here, maybe.
Yeah. Well, during the next video break, we'll try to readjust that. See if we can get him in a little bit louder. But thank you everyone for tuning in today for the kind words. Dana Valley says he found what he was looking for. 12 noon Fridays on Cigar Box Nation. That's right, buddy. It's the Gitty Gang Show. All right, so the next video we've got, I believe he's out there on YouTube as we speak, Mr. Kale down there.
Feeling much better.
Feeling better, got through all the troubles there. Singing an appropriate song, one of my favorites. It's from the, it's been around forever, it's in my various songbooks. Hey, speaking of songbooks, not too late to get your Irish and Celtic songbooks. Got them for mandolin, for cigar box guitar, for conventional guitar, all sorts of good stuff. Get you a CB Gitty Irish songbook, and by God, your blood will turn green before you know what's happening. But anyway, here's Kale doing Keep on the Sunny Side.
Well, howdy, folks. Happy Sunday morning. This is going to be a little bit of an ominous introduction here. I found out just a little bit ago that my wife tested positive for COVID. Some of her coworkers got sick, went out, they got tested, and you know, then she went and got tested and blah, blah, blah. Basically, she got her test result back today and she's got it. And that means I've probably got it. So I'm gonna go get tested tomorrow, figure out my status. But that's a depressing thing to start off your day. And But on the flip side, it is a beautiful sunny day in Texas today. Like, the temperature is beautiful. It's sunny. You can see I'm in a t-shirt. I kind of looked outside and said, hey, this is a good day to get bad news. You got to keep it on the sunny side. And then I was like, oh, wait, that's a song. So that's what I'm going to do for you here today for Sunday morning. And might have a lapse in content here because I might not be able to sing. If I do have it and it gets bad for me, I might not be able to sing. So hopefully everything goes well and I'll still be able to keep churning out the videos, and hopefully she has a really quick recovery. But if not, I guess this would be a great last song. So anyway, let's keep it on the sunny side, COVID edition. There's a dark and a troubled side of life. There's a bright and a sunny side too. Though you meet with the darkness and strife, the sunny side you also may view. So keep on sunny side, always on sunny side. Keep on the sunny side alive, and it will help us every day. It will brighten all the way if you keep on sunny side alive. Crushing hope that we cherish so dear. Well, the cloud and the storm will in time pass away. The sun will again shine bright and clear. So keep on sunny side, always on sunny side. Keep on the sunny side alive. It will help us every day and it will brighten. Every day, and it will brighten all the way if we can keep on the sunny side alive. Keep it on the sunny side, COVID edition, hoping for the best.
It's just tuned to itself at the moment. So thank you, Kale, for that. This is one of our mountain tenor kits. This is the bare or natural version that we built when I was creating the how-to guide. This is one of our Tupelo tenor kits. Actually, the Tupelo tenor predated the mountain tenor. This was the first one of these tenor guitar kits we released. Ooh, that sounds good. she's not in tune. This is the four-string version. It's electric. It's got that magnetic pickup. And this is the hubcap howler. You can see it has one of these hubcap paint can lid resonator cones in there. These three kits, Shane Spiel came to me a few weeks ago. He's like, hey, we need to do printed decorated versions of these kits and get them out there. We've been talking about this for a couple of years, honestly, and Shane's told me, all right, get off your butt. It's time to get this done. So just today, what we're calling the Red Barn series, these three kits, the Hubcap Howler, the Tupelo Tenor, and the Mountain Tenor are now available. Shane was good enough to put together a video showing off the three that he built, and pretty cool stuff. So here is Shane Spiel showing off the Red Barn series of guitars.
Hi, I'm Shane Spiel, and I am proud to announce the new Red Barn guitar kit series from CB Gitty. And I wanted to have a guitar that looked like it was made from old barn wood. So we came up with this design, and it's called the Red Barn. These are all based on cbgitty.com's very popular Mountain Tenor, Tupelo Tenor, and Howlin' Howler guitar kits. Except each of these come with a really cool old-fashioned Red Barn finish to them. The cool thing about these Gitty kits is they're easy enough to make on your dining room table. You don't need a massive shop. CB Gitty uses their UV printing process to give each one of these an old barn look. Each kit has its own distinct sound. Each one is available in three or four strings. I made mine with four strings. It's your choice. The Tupelo Tenor is loaded with a screaming lipstick tube pickup. Red Barn Mountain Tenor, fully acoustic. Every blues fan needs to own a dobro. The Red Barn Hubcap Howler, back porch blues machine here. All the same features are there from the original kits, and you can mod these if you want to round the backs of the necks as I have. In each of these, I added several coats of polyurethane. Boom, look at that shine. I didn't have to sand the body panels or anything. All I did was polyurethane right over top the cool Red Barn graphics. These are easy kits to put together. If I could do it, you can do it. Get yourself one today, or get all three. Go to cbgitty.com/redbarn to get your own. Look how the text wraps around the body. It starts here, even back here. We also added this cool dark burst to all the edges. cbgitty.com/redbarn. cbgitty.com/redbarn. All right, the demo video is supposed to end right here. However, I had so much fun with these guitars. Enjoy some bonus footage.
He's always up to something, isn't he? So you can check those out on cbgitty.com. Somebody there on YouTube mentioned that those necks need some color. And yes, you are right, they do. When they come in the kit, Shane may have mentioned, they are unstained. They're bare wood, hardwood, and you can stain them, you can dye them, you can do anything you want to them to make them stand out more from, to make it all, you can do whatever you want. That's the short version. Some people liking the acoustic version best, others like the hard drive and electric version. I'm kind of partial to the resonator, the hubcap howler there. I think that's got that good, just enough touch of that dobro kind of sound. Just for fun now, I think Danny's going to lead us in another one.
Hopefully and my sound will be better this time.
Oh, yeah. His mic was on mute, so
yeah,
all you were hearing
know how that
was
happened.
Coming through my mic. Yeah. So we got that sorted out, so you can hear him now. And I'd like to offer a prize of all of the internets to the first person who can name this song that we're about to do.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
just a small town girl.
Tricked you.
Living in a lonely world. She took the midnight train going anywhere. Just a city boy. Born and raised in South Detroit. He took the midnight train going anywhere. Uh-huh. They took that midnight train going anywhere. A singer in a smoky room. Smell of wine and cheap. Smile, they can say the night. It goes on and on and on and on. Strangers waiting up and down the boulevard. Their shadows searching in the night. Street lights, people living just to find. Emotion hiding somewhere in the night. Working hard to get my bill. Everybody wants a thrill. Paying anything to roll the dice. Just one more time. Some will win, some will lose. Some are born to sing the blues. Oh, the movie never ends. It goes on and on and on and on. Strangers waiting up and down the boulevard. Their shadows searching in the night. Street lights, people living just to find emotion hiding somewhere in the night. Don't stop believing. Hold on to that feeling. Street lights, people. Don't stop believing.
Not Wagon Wheel. First time he started playing that, I'm like, Wagon Wheel? We just did that. And then it wasn't. So.
You stopped believing.
Well, you know, you got to believe, I guess. So they tell me. So thank you again, everyone, for tuning in. Some fun and interesting things going on. So without too much further ado, there's always a little more ado when I'm announcing. We've got the video from our new buddy, Dean. Our buddy Dean up in Alberta.
Yes.
Yes. And then,
there you go.
I don't know.
It's right there.
I'm just, nudge, nudge. We've got our video from Dean. Poke.
Oh, you mean right now?
Because that, yeah.
Oh. That's. Thank you.
Nice. That's two brothers playing the same guitar, I believe, that was built by Dean there, sent it in to us. All right, so now without further ado, we want to run the three videos of the top three winners from the 2022 New Orleans Cigar Box Guitar Festival International Video Contest. Ooh, boy, that's a lot to get out. Mm. Could we start with the third place and work up? All right, so third place was Pierce Dipner, doing a nice rock and bluesy kind of piece. Second place, Aaron Coburn from Middleburg, Ohio, which I believe is down near Cincinnati. And then first place, Sergi Estella, a guy whose videos we've featured on here before. He's got the 12-pack guitar he made out of beer cans. Does amazing work over there in Spain. So we're going to run all three, one after the other. Third place, second place, and then first place. And even if you've already watched them, they're good enough. Watch them again, by God.
Hello, my name is Pierce Dipner from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Today I'll be playing my original song, Fool's Gold, as my submission for the CB Gitty International Cigar Box Guitar Video Playoffs.
I am Aaron Coburn, and I'm from Middletown, Ohio. I will be performing the song I literally just wrote called Call Me the Villain, and it'll be on my Lunchbox Spider-Man guitar and also my other Cigar Box guitar. And I will be performing this as my submission to the CB Gitty International CBG Video Playoffs. Let's do it. You don't even know me. You're saying you hate who I am. I guess you're lonely. Did I get under your skin? Show me your face, come on, show me. What I can't see doesn't hurt me. In your eyes, I'm the bad guy. 'Cause I'm making something of my life. Here to see me winning. 'Cause you can't win. Independent, I'm happy by myself. I got no bad intentions, not here to sell myself. Different isn't bad, you should learn to accept that. No, I'm still your villain, but at least I'm not a brat. You need to see me winning, 'cause you can't.
Hi, I am Sergi Estella from Rubí, a city beside Barcelona. I will be performing a song from my new album Blood Like Wine. The song is called Rattlesnake. I will play this song as my submission to the CBGITI International CBG Video Playoffs. So, cheers.
We'll be right back.
Yes, that was hard to judge, even as not one of the official judges. Just trying to pick three out of the top 10 that I preferred was pretty darn hard. So congratulations to Sergi, to Aaron, and to Pierce. Awesome work. Congratulations to everyone who entered the top 10 finalists. It was really a great, great contest. And thanks to Collins Kirby and Paige Davis and everybody down there at the New Orleans Cigar Box Guitar Fest for making it happen. Prizes supplied by CB Gitty. So we're going to go out on a little bit of a sadder note today. Several weeks ago, we lost a member of the CB Gitty family, Cheryl Caldwell, who I became friends with several years ago, and then she came to work here 3 years ago, passed away after the onset of unexpectedly, let's say. Passed away, and we haven't really had a chance here on the show to do anything in memory of her, so Danny and I would like to do a song here, an old spiritual. We'll end on a hymn, and we'll send it out to Cheryl and her family, her husband John, and her daughter and grandkids there. She will be missed here at CB Gitty, that's for sure. Let it be, dear Lord, let it be.
dear Lord, close to thee.
Thank you, everyone, for tuning in, playing along. We will be with you once again next week. We're still figuring out what to do for an Irish show for this year because we've got gigs on St. Patrick's Day itself. Might not have any voice left for the day after, which would be a regular Gitty Gang show day, Friday. So we'll see. To be announced. And we hope to see you all again here next week.